Hey, all you drunks out there, I'm Axel, this is DB.
What up?
We're coming to you from the VIP Lounge in Sonny's Pub in Southwest Florida with another episode of Beer or Bust, the show where we drink a six-pack of beer and rate it in five different categories for you to determine if this is a beer you should drink or a bust you should avoid. What do you got for us today, DB?
Sweet Baby Jesus is what is on today's label.
What are you doing?
What do you mean, what am I doing?
Why are you talking like that? Why are you dressed like that?
Today's flavor.
Right. It's Sweet Baby Jesus.
Sweet Baby Jesus.
No, it's not Jesus. That's Jesus.
No. The J is silent in the word.
No,
that's... You're reading it wrong.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Sweet Baby Jesus.
No, it's probably everyone got it mixed up. He was in a manger. Like, most of us were born in mangers.
That's true. Joseph and Mary made a pilgrimage to Bethlehem. They weren't living there. They had to go there, and then they just had an offspring once they got there and was counted as one of their people. Yeah, Sweet Baby Jesus. And we have Jesus here, Buddy Christ, joining us for today's episode.
Sweet Baby Jesus.
All right, well, in spite of it actually being Sweet Baby Jesus, I think you should lose the Cheech Marin routine there.
Okay.
Lose the voice, too.
Sorry, guys. This is from, what is this, from Maryland?
DuClaw Brewing. Well, the first thing I didn't notice about this beer is that it's a chocolate peanut butter porter.
Yeah, and I have never had a porter, or at least I can say I don't even know what a porter is, so I have no clue what we're honestly getting ready to drink.
All right, let's crack these bad boys open.
All right.
Oh, wow. Smells like coffee.
But, well, you know, I have to say,
not even coffee, like
it's this might be a Guinness. Why don't we go with Guinness with chocolate, right?
Yeah, that's not making it any better.
I know. I'm ready.
Oh fuck!
It's gonna be stout. That's exactly what it reminds me of. It tastes like we're drinking Guinness. With, oh my god.
Don't get me wrong, it's kind of tasty. I could see why somebody would like it, but man, it's going to be heavy and thick,
yeah.
And I don't know, getting through three of them, and especially chugging the last one. I'm predicting a failure on the chugability challenge.
Yeah, and, I mean, I can already see this is going to be heavy.
We might have met our match today on Beer or Bust.
Sweet Baby Jesus. My first impression on this is, oh no.
Sweet Baby Jesus. I mean, it just hits you in the stomach real hard.
Yeah.
It's tasty. It's tasty,
yeah.
But it's just,
yeah.
It's like drinking a chocolate mousse.
Yeah, like burnt wood mixed with like coffee grinds, and then they lit it on fire, and then they mix it in the beer.
Kind of stays with you right in this area, too.
I bet you if we chewed on coffee grinds right now, we probably would get the same taste.
Yeah.
Sorry, the claw.
Sweet Baby Jesus, turn this into wine.
Yes. No, we should be.
Man,
like,
that's a bad sign. I'm burping like that already.
Well, no,
I already
burped a silent one out, but
yeah,
I got one out. I'm like, you gotta let them out because I can't imagine these being a built up one. Ooh.
I usually don't burp like that until after the chugability. Now I'm doing that not even a quarter way through the first beer.
Ooh, and I'm not even looking at this chugability.
When Sweet Baby Jesus said, "Drink of my blood," I didn't think he was literally gonna put blood in the drink.
He says, "Respect my." Listen, I absolutely respect the fluid if you change the flavor. Oh.
I wouldn't even want to eat chocolate peanut butter cookies while drinking a regular beer, let alone make the beer out of the chocolate peanut butter cookies.
I'd like to get a better understanding of why they even created this.
They're angry. They're angry, vengeful God, and they want to bring their wrath on judgment down on mankind for being sinners.
Okay.
All right, well, let's talk about something other than the drink.
Yes.
Let's talk about the label.
The label.
Sweet Baby Jesus. It jumps out at you.
It definitely does. It's got that zigzag. We should have known from right there. It's not even light.
Yeah. I feel like they were purposely deceptive. They've got the name of the beer just blasting out in your face, and then they hid it almost camouflaged in a soft gold mixed in with the green chocolate peanut butter.
And we're coming to realize that we need to stop focusing on just the labels and read what we have in our hands. Because, man, I tell you what. I mean, it literally says a classic full-bodied, robust porter with smooth, dry finish and just enough hops. Balance and aromas and flavors in roasted malt, chocolate, and peanut butter. So rich that just one sip and you will exclaim the name.
Just one sip and you'll be shouting out,
Sweet Baby Jesus. The label's just plain. It looks like it's a kind of a hipster label. It's a hipster label. It's it blasts. It's all blast in your face.
It kind of reminds me of the Gang's Bar. Not quite the same vibrant yellow, but yeah, on the label, not colorful. Doesn't really need to be. I like the camo colors.
It's like a suit. Mm-hmm. Like all black.
It's literally yelling at you, kind of like a preacher. I give the label a 3 out of 5.
3 out of 5. Okay, fine. I'll give it a 3 out of 5.
Oh, Sweet Baby Jesus, why have you forsaken us? It's all for you, the viewing audience.
Yes,
I certainly hope you appreciate this.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, we just rated the labels. We can get into the price. It was also $10.49.
The price. Let's hope that this was on sale for $5.99.
It was not. Sweet Baby Jesus. This cost $10.49.
I'm gonna give it a thumbs down on the fucking price. Absolutely.
Maybe if they were paying us $10.49.
Doesn't have an aftertaste.
Are you sure? That's all I'm tasting is the aftertaste.
Yeah, it kind of goes away right now.
Not for me.
Well, I'm not as low as you are either. So you know what I'm saying. And should I go ahead and throw two of these in? Because it seems like those two better be frozen when we drink it. So I'll be right back.
I'll be here with our Lord and Savior.
With your Lord and Savior?
Verily, verily, I say unto thee, you are my brethren, and I am yours. Those who wish to enter the kingdom of God, give away all your earthly possessions. Why aren't I in focus? There we go. No! This was so much easier when I was on the mount. Give away all your earthly possessions and follow me. Okay, that's enough out of you. No, we're not giving away all our earthly possessions. That's some, like, communist bullshit that you're rambling about now. Everyone's sharing, everyone giving away their things for the poor.
If they are,
we're not commies. This is America. We're Republicans.
I want one of them Bentleys from your homeboy. What's that dude that's got everything?
Joel Osteen.
Yeah, Joel Osteen wouldn't even give us tickets. Sweet Baby Jesus. Man, okay, so here.
We're normally through our first beers by now. I don't even want to finish it. I want to give this to the plants.
Oh, okay. Oh. I drank as far as I can fucking go. Yeah.
I'm angry. I'm going to say it.
I mean, it's like almost a dread to drink the next beer. Right?
It's just like, it's sitting on my tongue. It's just, it's attacking me while I'm just sitting idle. Everybody knows that in the Bible, Jesus' first miracle was turning water into wine. But there's some dispute on this. Some people say, oh, it wasn't alcoholic, it was just grape juice. Other people say, of course it was wine. It says wine. Why would it say wine if it meant juice? Let's ask the religious bitch.
According to the New International Version of the Holy Bible, John chapter 2, verses 1 through 11, Jesus, his mother Mary, and some of the first men to follow him as his disciples were invited to a wedding at Cana in Galilee. The bridegroom must not have been very well prepared because the banquet ran out of wine. Mary went to Jesus and told him the terrible news. Jesus replied, "Dear woman, why do you involve me? My time has not yet come." This technically means Jesus broke the fourth commandment by not immediately honoring his mother's wishes, but let's just move past it. Mary was not deterred by Jesus' reluctance, and she told the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." This technically means Mary disobeyed the Son of God, but let's just move past it. Nearby, there were 6 30-gallon stone jars, the kind Jews use for ceremonial washing, and Jesus instructed the servants to fill the jars with water to the brim, then draw some out and take it to the master of the banquet. Sounds kind of gross there, drinking from jars used for bathing, but let's just move past it. When the master of the banquet tasted the water that had been turned to wine, he called the bridegroom aside and said, "Everyone brings out the choice wine first, and then the cheaper wine after the guest had too much to drink. But you have saved the best till now." So yes, the wedding guest blew through the choice wine, polished off the cheaper wine, and then Jesus cranked that party up to 11 and blasted everyone's nips off with the best wine they had all night. This was the first miraculous sign Jesus performed in Galilee, revealing his glory and earning his disciples' faith. I'm the religious bitch, and Jesus and I love you 3,000.
Why can't we have stronger alcohol that covers the taste of this bullshit that I'm drinking?
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, if he made the best wine of the night, why can't he make a freaking decent porter?
All right, let's go ahead and kick open a second beer so we can get through
this.
Look
how much it's sweating.
I know, it's already half, like, and we're, listen, that's the other thing in the, you know, Florida, it's hot, and you were drinking, that's the whole thing. Maybe this beer would taste better up north because it's freezing cold, you know, like an icy or something.
Definitely wouldn't taste good in Bethlehem. Sweet Baby Jesus, I don't even like the smell of the second beer.
Oh my gosh.
I don't think I can do it.
So, on the box, hang on. So, it's malty, hop level. It's malty. It's not. It's more in the malty side than the hoppy side. Body, mouthfeel. It's in the heavy instead of thin side. So that's, we're getting all these feelings. Yeah, yeah, it's heavy. Oh, and it is, between the color, it is dark as shit. There's a note on the bottom of the box. And it says, as I read, "Dear person with the awesome taste."
Why are they lying?
Is that how we're starting this off after I drank the beer? "Thank you for sampling our beer. I want my money back. With this one simple, insightful act, you've proven yourself both wise and incredibly physically attractive."
I feel neither. I feel very
That's
stupid.
Exactly what this says. "Since 1996, how are you in business with this beer? DuClaw Brewing Company has been brewing a massive collection. Can you please send us the collection that tastes good?"
Yeah. I would love to see what's actually paying the bills, because
yes,
I know it's not this.
Yes, it's not this. Listen, that's why I was saying, DuClaw Brewing Company, we're not trying you. We want to try other beers. "A massive collection of the most creative and finely crafted beers in Maryland." So, we're definitely going to hit you up, because I want to see what you guys have, because I don't think this is the one you wanted us to review, trust me.
Sweet Baby Jesus.
Sweet
the alcohol content on this is 6.2%.
Now, it gets me lit. I am lit, right? I'm slurring words, right? Slurring words a little bit.
Speaking in tongues.
Speaking in tongues, you know. Not that, you know, how, what it is, how it is.
Sweet Baby Jesus. This does not taste good at all. It's rich in all the wrong ways. It's bitter in all the wrong ways. It's like doing a shot of liquor with a mouthful of chocolate mousse. It hurts. I don't like it. I can't drink it. This is a bad, bad flavor. I'm giving it a 1 out of 5.
Sweet Baby Jesus. Now the taste. Okay. Listen, it's smooth. I really don't have an aftertaste after I sit here and talk and bullshit. Listen, but it is absolutely a disgusting fucking flavor. It's an entire mouth of coffee grinds. I give it a 0.05.
That's fair. So that brings our overall score to 0.75. Just 0.75.
Yeah.
I hope you're happy with yourself, Sweet Baby Jesus. Sweet Baby Jesus, it's time to decide if this is a beer or a bust, and I think you guys know already that this is definitely a bust.
I will throw it at the camera.
You know it's bad when we're calling it short. We didn't even finish our second beers, let alone even want to attempt the chugability challenge. This is a total fail on all attempts.
I mean, if you want to, like, trick your friends, great gag beer. Oh my god.
If you want information from somebody, strap them to a table and funnel this down their throats.
If you're trying to get rid of beer out of your refrigerator, your friend comes over drunk, sweet baby Jesus. Hand him a sweet baby Jesus. They might rethink what they're doing in life.
I think that's what they meant when they said give up all your belongings.
Are you sure you want to do the checkability contest?
If you own sweet baby Jesus, give it up.
I'm going to go get the other two beers. And I'm going to go ahead and try to do checkability contest for you guys.
You're going
to
do it, DB?
I am literally going to try to do the checkability contest for you guys.
Bigger man than me, I'm not doing it.
I mean, it tastes like trash. But we're going to go ahead and do the checkability contest. I'm going to try to talk Axel into this.
I can't wait to see you do it. Make it happen.
All right.
What did I say about letting kids into the bar?
I told them they can only play up front with the electronics and the rats, whatever ones they got left out there.
That is a lawsuit going somewhere to happen. Sweet baby Jesus, this one broke me. I never thought I'd get beaten by a beer, but here we are.
Okay.
Good luck, fella.
All right. Oh, yes.
You want me to pray for you?
No. Oh my god.
That's way farther than I would have gotten. I think it was because of all my prayers.
Alright, checkability is absolutely zero.
Fail.
Yeah, I just had to make sure we had a number. Sorry, yeah, absolutely not. There's no fucking way. Yeah, zero. Garbage. The checkability is final thoughts. This is bullshit. This is some prank-ass beer that they sell at Spencer's. Who the fuck made this? What the fuck, sweet baby Jesus, my nutsack?
Alright, well, this has been an episode of Beer or Bust. Sweet baby Jesus is a clear bust.
Yeah, absolute bust.
We'll see you next time with something much better. Yeah. I hope.
And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine after rain. And it's so hard to say goodbye.